Hello everybody. So I'm very excited to show you this little experiment that I did with decorating a dreidel. So I found this box of four wooden dreidels on Amazon. I was a little bit worried because it says large wooden dreidel, singular, on the package. But then I opened it up and voila, there are four. And I'm doing these because I like to make little things at the holiday time for my coworkers. So this is just one alternative to Christmas tree ornaments. This is white acrylic paint, just from Target. And I could have spray painted this white. I forget why I didn't. maybe it was raining. I can't remember. But I've done two more of these since recording this. And I did spray paint the other ones with white. And I don't know. I feel like if you do a thin coat with painting, the dry time's pretty much the same, and I use my hairdryer to help speed up the drying process anyway. So, I'm like figuring all this out as I go. So to help it dry, I cut a little X in the bottom of that Dixie cup, paper Dixie cup. And just stuck the handle in there. I did not paint the handle and just let it dry. So I'm using this resin for my decorative layer, if you will. I will later coat the dreidel with a more thick, better quality resin that's actually made for tumblers that I use on my tumblers. So I'm just using this more because I am experimenting, and it ended up turning out really pretty. So I measured 10 mLs of parts A and B for a total of 20 mLs. And I don't care for this resin at all. It's really thin, but for this particular part, it didn't really matter. If you can see the tumbler spinning over on the left side of the screen, I used this type of resin to coat a camouflage pattern that I did with alcohol inks. And even though the alcohol ink was completely dry, the resin just gave terrible, terrible fish eyes. And I will never use that resin again on tumblers. But it worked really well for this base layer on the dreidel, and you'll see shortly that I used the runoff to create two coasters, one of which did not turn out and the other did. So I will show you all of that. So once I had the 20 milliliters mixed, I divided it 10 and 10 into two little cups because I want two colors. And I use broken popsicle sticks. So one thing that I dislike about fluid art is waste. So I knew I would be pouring colored resin over the dreidel, and I wanted to catch the runoff in this silicone coaster mold. This is the white resin dye pigment. Kind of like a thick paint consistency. I have to squeeze that bottle really hard to get any out. But a little does go a long way. So that coaster mold, I was cleaning out with alcohol and a coffee filter just because it's been sitting on my shelf for a while and I wanted to get all the debris out of it. This is a resin dye. It is called Blueberry. And it looks like alcohol ink, but it does not act like alcohol ink. A little bit goes a very long way. I do think I started with 2 drops. I end up adding a little bit more to make the color darker. But you can't use this type of resin dye on tumblers or other things where you would expect it to act like alcohol ink, because it won't. So just give it a stir, making sure it's the depth of color that I'm looking for. Sorry, it's really late at night, and I just wanted to share this with you as soon as possible in case you wanted to make one. So my handy dandy heat gun that I've had since I was in college, not heat gun, oh my gosh, hot glue gun. So I'm painting the top now that the other parts are dry. So I'm going, and the other thing is I only had like half of a hot glue stick left. I didn't realize it, but my son had used up all my hot glue for a school project. So you'll see I have a creative way of pushing out that half of a hot glue stick. So, okay guys, here's how I attach the dreidel to my turner. As I was digging around for hot glue, I found this old, I guess like SD card holder or case, that plastic thing. I could have just used like a bottle cap or anything kind of small that I could poke a hole in, and I couldn't find our drill. So I was just using various screwdrivers to poke a hole wide enough to fit the handle of that dreidel right in there, nice and snug. And there it is. So I'm going to hot glue the plastic piece to the end of my rod that goes on the turner. I attempted to tape the handle, thinking that maybe the tape would protect the handle from the resin, but it just wasn't working, so I took it off. And I will describe shortly how I handle the handle. So to push that hot glue out, I was using a paintbrush. You can see I had to like push it and pull the trigger at the same time. So I'm just holding that plastic piece onto the end of the rod until it dries. As you know, hot glue dries very fast. And I was actually pretty proud of myself. I'm not an engineer. I work with engineers, but I am not an engineer. And I really had to like figure all this out as I went along, because I could not find anything, at least not on YouTube, for how to do this. And I tried searching, trust me. All right, so we are making sure the coaster is nice and clean and underneath the turning dreidel. So now I am just pouring about half of the white colored resin all over the dreidel, and then about half of the blue. Actually, maybe almost all of the blue. And then the rest of the white. I knew I wanted a marble look. That's all I was after. It's a nice swirly look. I used the popsicle sticks to kind of get into the areas that were difficult, I guess. I also scraped both cups completely clean. And this is sped up. I forget if this is double time or more, but I reversed the direction. I think I purposely stopped my turner every once in a while just to let some of the excess drip off, because I didn't want it. Yeah, here we go. I didn't want it pooling too much. I just wanted the dreidel to be covered. And as you can see, I was able to catch all of the runoff into my coaster. And so I'm not sure if I show it, but eventually I do torch this just to get rid of the bubbles and give it a good spritz with 91% isopropyl alcohol. All right, so I took that runoff that went into the coaster mold, and I knew I needed to add more resin, so I mixed up some more of the same brand, added some gold alcohol ink around the edges and the center, and then poured more resin into the middle. And this is sped up, but as you can see, the momentum of the resin getting poured into the middle pushes it all out to the edge, and then it kind of flows back into the center to create that that effect. And then I was like, I don't know, on a roll. And so I wanted to make another coaster. And this second one actually turns out way better than that first one. I will fix the camera. So I put gold blue alcohol ink, not that resin dye, I don't think. I forget now. And white alcohol ink. Yeah, that was blue alcohol ink. And then look at that really cool effect. It's like dendrites that are growing in there. So I will give you an update on the coasters. So what I didn't like was the lack of contrast in the colors. So I took some blue alcohol ink, not the same as the resin dye, but roughly the same color. I think this was called Cobalt by Pixis. And then I add, I think, just one drop of my white alcohol ink. I didn't want to overdo it on the white because, again, I was trying to achieve more contrast. And I knew that the colors would swirl even more, so I just left it at the one drop. And here we are, sped way up. And this worked out really well. So I took it off my turner and just held it vertically in both directions just to get a little bit of upward and downward movement. And I wasn't sure how the resin would settle in the long run, but I was really happy with it. So this all did work out. But I did make sure that there wasn't this ridiculous like excess amount on there where it would pool and then potentially change the shape of the dreidel. So I decided that that coaster needed more white, again, for contrast. And because this is sped up, you can see how the alcohol ink moves. So I took my heat gun, just shot it right there in the middle to kind of push the resin out so that it would also start to come back in and just create some really cool patterns. Excuse me. So even though I cover all of my projects with food nets, the coaster on the right ends up getting a fiber of some sort in it. I don't think it was a hair, but it was like, I don't know, fabric or something in it the next morning, and I realized it too late. So that coaster did not work out in the end, but such is life. So I was using that popsicle stick to just make sure that there was not an excess of resin at the top. So I tried to dig out that fiber that I was telling you about the next morning, but it did not work out. That one did work out. Love it, love it, love it. Barely any air bubbles. So I was excited about that. And pardon all the spray paint on my arm and hands. But the next morning, yep, it was good when I checked on it. So what am I doing? I am taking it off of the turner and giving you a nice close up. This is exactly what I was going for. I was just worried that the bottom of it would be, I don't know, like a no longer a point where you could actually use it as a dreidel. So my intention was not for this to purely be decorative. I still want people to be able to play the game. So I knew this would happen. The resin did sort of pool just a little bit around the handle where it was attached to that plastic piece. So I just took my X-Acto knife. And again, this is just the next morning where it's still really soft. And I just cut away at any of that excess. And at this point, I wasn't 100% sure what I was going to do with that handle. Was I going to try to resin it and make it match the rest? But you'll see shortly that that's not what I end up doing, because I could not figure out a way in my brain to attach the dreidel to the turner with the handle facing outward, unless I used just like a ton of tape to tape the dreidel to the turner. And I didn't want to do that. So as I was touching it, I got my fingerprints on it because it's still soft. So I used the heat gun to get those off. All right. So Cricut Design Space. I'm currently using the free trial. So I did find the letters that go on the dreidel. I'm not going to attempt to pronounce them. I do have them written down because I had my kids learn how to play the game, and I let them use chocolate chips to play the game. I made the letters probably a little too big. I think I went 1.5 inches tall for this one, and I probably should have backed that off to 1.25 or just 1 inch. But I made it work. I didn't have to redo anything. So I am very, very new at all of this, but especially with using the Cricut. I had been using the one that's for free at our public library for a while, but I did find a Cricut Joy on Facebook Marketplace used, and I just love it. It's like exactly what I need to make these crafts a little bit more personalized. So application wasn't 100% perfect, but it was good. So this had hardened even more. I waited several hours. And so what I decided to do with the handle, I was trying to decide between the two gold glitters, and I decided to go with the one that matched the vinyl a little bit more. So I just took some Mod Podge and I should have just used the lid as the cup. I don't know why I didn't, because I just used such a small amount. And here's where, after I put the Mod Podge on, I make a mistake of dumping the glitter right back into the cup that has the Mod Podge in it. I meant to dump it on the paper, but oh well, I put the excess back in the thing, and I use the glittered Mod Podge to paint one of the other dreidels. So it all worked out in the end. So that one I paint with the glittered Mod Podge, and then I dump even more glitter over top just to get better coverage on that. That one I end up, after it dries, I seal it and I put a coat of resin over top, and then I will probably print the Hebrew letters on blue vinyl and then put those on there. This one, I did the gold handle. I will probably resin that one too. I ended up having to reattach the plastic piece. It did fall off, but if you have any suggestions for how else this could be done, I am all ears and eyes if I read your comments. When I put that handle back in to the holder there, some of the glitter did move, even though I had sealed it and everything. So I ended up redoing it. It wasn't a big deal to me. So this resin is my good stuff. This is the tumbler resin. This is much thicker. It's UV protectant. It has a UV protectant factor in it. It's food safe. This is what I use on the majority of my tumblers. The one I showed you earlier, that was just like an experiment. So I let the runoff again fall into the coaster mold because I needed to seal that anyway. And I just use my gloved hand to smooth it out, make sure there's not a ton of excess. And then at some point I go in with my, I think I switched over to a silicone scraper just to get the top of that dreidel and make sure that resin is not pooling. I will torch, I will spritz with alcohol, and then I will let this cure. Because this resin is much thicker, sometimes the torch does not do enough to get the bubbles out, so I have to use my heat gun and really get in there, get those bubbles. Letting the excess run off. So I just stop the turner. And there it starts to break. And thankfully I catch it. So I was out of hot glue, remember? Out of hot glue. I need to get to the dollar store and get some more. So I just put that plastic piece on one of my stands and kind of took a risk and let it just sit there. So I'm currently using epoxy resin to attach that plastic piece back to my rod. Because I don't have super glue either. I'm like really low on a lot of things. So here was just like a status picture of the three pieces, all just kind of drying, sitting in various orientations in different types of cups, kind of off to the side. And I coated the handle with resin in that cup. So it works. And here it is. I got some chocolate gelt coins from Target. And I just love it. And I can't wait to hear from my coworkers. Happy Hanukkah. Happy holidays. Thanks for watching.